Assalamu alaikum, Sharmina. I'm here to help you, to facilitate you in studying Pakistan studies particularly. Well, to start with, in paper 1, you get 2-4 marks questions to do in section 2. Now, normally, students ask me as to how they can get full marks in 4 marks questions, because normally they are unaware of the way to answer a question in through which they can get full marks. Well, the formula is really very easy. The basic formula is related to the question being asked. You need to write one date, one name, maybe of a person or a place, or 2 facts relevant to the question being asked. If you are able to describe them well in your own words, definitely you're going to get full marks. On the other hand, there are certain questions, for example, the one that I'm going to start with you today, this question. Here, in such questions, as such, there is no mention of a date or no relevant date required for this question or any name. So for such questions, the basic thing is to write 4 main points or facts or more even related and relevant again to the question being asked. So if you are able to describe them well, you will again get full marks. So now, quickly to start with this particular question, who was Aurangzeb Alamgir? Now, this is a question that has come quite often in the past papers. And the easiest way to solve this answer is to write about what kind of a person he was. First of all, who he was, then what kind of a person he was, and then to describe his policies. So that will definitely get you full marks. For example, Aurangzeb, he was the last great emperor of the Mughal Empire. We know. Well, great. We are here saying great emperor because it is said that it was Aurangzeb Alamgir who was the last Mughal ruler to do advancement and development for the empire and of the empire. After him, his successors were really, very weak. And they couldn't do much for the empire. That is why we call him the last, but the last great emperor of the Mughal Empire. And then he took over the throne from Shah Jahan, his father. And then you need to know how was he able to get the throne ultimately after defeating and killing his brothers and then father. Then he was a courageous man. Now, courageous in what sense? Because he fought several wars and battles and then was successful as well. And then he was also able to increase his empire. The Mughal Empire, it became very vast during his lifetime because he increased the size towards the southern part of India. Then, in this way, he was courageous. And then, as I already told you about the wars, he was an able, capable and an efficient administrator as well. He administered the empire really very nicely. There is no need to go into the details as to how he administered it because the question deals with Aurangzeb Alamgir himself, not his policies or the way of administration. So you need to just touch upon these things. Then he was deeply a religious man. Now, deeply a religious man in 2 sense. Number one, he wrote out copies of Quran and then he did a lot, built mosques as well, and you know, you can always add it here that he built mosques, for example, Pearl Mosque. You can also mention that, the Pearl Mosque. And then he, in the other sense, that he imposed jizya tax on non-Muslims as well. He demolished their temples as well. So he is considered to be extremist in this particular regard, as he used to demolish the temples. But on the other hand, we also see him from an emperor point of view. We see him as supportive to his non-Muslim people as well, as he gave donations for building the for construction of temples as well. Then he was a just ruler and had a very simple character. He led a very basic life, a simple life, and he was just, you know, emphasizing more on expanding his empire and administering his empire efficiently and effectively. Thank you.